Well, New Hampshire is not in a salt crisis, but those iconic Portsmouth salt piles are waiting for ships to resupply them. Now, the state and municipalities are doing okay. They get first priority on what's there, and they've been filling storage sheds throughout the season, but it's left commercial plow operations scrambling. Trucks are loading up what little salt there is. What started as an acre and a half stored at the port, owned and distributed by International Salt, is down to a few small piles.
And I want to say there was close to 70,000 tons here, give or take. So it's been a hard winter.
A recent shipload headed here from South America was diverted to another hard-hit state.
Well, right now we do not have a ship scheduled, unfortunately. I can tell you that the owners of the salt, International Salt Company, have told me that what's left here is going only to the state of New Hampshire DOT sheds.
The other major salt supplier, Granite State Minerals, expects ships after the 23rd of February. They're restricting who gets theirs for now, too.
Right now, only towns and municipalities are allowed to get salt. Commercial contractors are currently shut down.
That's an issue for O'Neill Landscaping's crews that service 47 commercial properties.
Per application, we go through about 20 to 25 tons of salt.
O'Neill is mixing it with calcium and sand, working storm to storm.
So we've looked as far as Portland, Maine, and down far as Chelsea, Mass., and the next step is going to New York.
To get salt. Meantime, municipalities like Exeter fall back on their storage capacity and will get priority.
We still have about 300 to 400 tons in that shed, and it lasts us a ways.
The state DOT says it is in good shape, but has fielded calls from other states looking for salt and had to say no as it keeps an eye on the situation. Reporting live in Portsmouth, Jennifer Crompton, WMUR News 9.